Let's now talk about the idea of mutually exclusive events. Two events are said to be mutually exclusive if the occurrence of one precludes the occurrence of the other. That means if one happens, the other cannot. If that's the situation, then they are said to be mutually exclusive. As example, let event A be somebody's a male, event B be somebody's a female. Without messing around with Mother Nature, A and B are mutually exclusive. They're not the same. They're either male or they're a female. Think in terms of flipping a coin. The event A, observe a head. The event B, get a tail. Those are mutually exclusive. They cannot happen at the same time. Now, given that table with the work hours, the freshman, sophomore, and so forth, let's take a look at one event that's mutually exclusive and explain why the thing is mutually exclusive, and one event that is not mutually exclusive, and let's discuss the idea of why it is not mutually exclusive. Okay, so let's find a mutually exclusive event. How about if I say event A is freshman? Find an event that is mutually exclusive. Well, actually, I see three of them. Sophomore is mutually exclusive. You can't be a freshman and a sophomore at the same time. Junior is mutually exclusive. You can't be a freshman and a junior at the same time. And senior is mutually exclusive. Matter of fact, when you have the data on the table like this, all the columns will be mutually exclusive. Likewise, if I say event A is they work less than or equal to 5 hours, then what's mutually exclusive? Well, this is mutually exclusive, this one is, and this one is. All the roles would be mutually exclusive. There's nobody in here that worked between 10 and 20 hours and less than 5. It's one or the other. There's no overlap. So how about two events that are not mutually exclusive? Well, if I say event A is sophomore, find an event that is not mutually exclusive. Well, that's actually any of the role events. Worked less than 5 hours is not mutually exclusive because they share 18 people. There are 18 people that were both sophomores and they work less than or equal to 5 hours. Any column would not be mutually exclusive of the rows unless you had a zero in here. If there's zero in here, then it would be because they still don't share anything. Okay, what about probabilities? Let's talk about probabilities for a second. Let's find one real quick here. 66 out of 280. Let's take a look at the idea of freshmen and sophomores. Those are mutually exclusive, right? So the probability they observe somebody that's a freshman is 66 out of 280. Okay? Sophomores is 56. The probability they observe a sophomore was 56 out of 280. Now, if you observe a freshman, then what is the probability that you also observe a sophomore? That's going to be 0. If you observe a sophomore, what's the probability you also observed a freshman? That is also 0. Because they're mutually exclusive, once I say I observed a freshman, then everything that can happen has to be in my freshman column. None of the sophomores are. So if I tell you I observed a freshman, what's the probability that it was also a sophomore? That's going to be 0 every time. Because, look at the definition, if nothing else, one event precludes the occurrence. So if freshmen happen, then I'm telling you the number of ways sophomore can happen is in fact 0. The number of ways it happens by the number in the sample space, 0 over 280, is going to be 0. Okay, that pretty much wraps it up for the idea of mutually exclusive for right now.